Kiosk has been around for some time. I think most of us have used it in our own travel, whether in Changi or in other parts of the world. But the key thing that differentiates our kiosk from the other kiosks that you see is design. So two things, hardware design as well as software design. So this kiosk is unique to Changi. You can't find this machine anywhere else because we designed this from scratch with the service provider as well as software. In many other airports, you will see they left it to the airlines to introduce their own application. So as a result, when passengers come through the departure hall, you see an array of screens that are showing different things. But in Changi, we work with the airlines very closely to introduce a welcome screen that is consistent across all airlines. So no matter which row that you are departing in, you will be seeing the same screen that greets you the first time you come forth to the kiosk. So now maybe let me just go through a demonstration so we can flow through the entire process quickly. So we follow the instructions on the screen, touch screen to begin. Okay, today we're flying with AirAsia. My colleague Sally will be helping us in the demonstration. So same thing as you will see in the main terminals today, and you'll be familiar with this if you do online check-in or mobile check-in. Same options for you to retrieve your bookings. In this case, I'll retrieve through the booking reference. Okay, so it's retrieving the booking, and if the booking has a few names, it will show on this screen. In this case, there's only one passenger on this booking, and she's Jialing, and she's flying to Kuala Lumpur tonight. So this is really early check-in. The flight is 9:20 p.m. and she's checking in now. Okay, then we're requested to scan the travel document. Okay, so at this point, it asks whether we have a check-in bag. So for purpose of today's demonstration, there is one bag that we're going to be checking in. So a couple of advisory messages that we have packed our own bags. The bags do not contain any dangerous goods or prohibited items. You indicate that we want to print one bag tag. So this would be a process that will be new to many passengers, for them to self-tag their bag tag. So to help passengers understand how that works, there are a few things. At the back of the bag tag, this is the front of the bag tag with the barcodes, and then the back contains instructions on how to do that in two simple steps. Step one, step two. Essentially, step one is to peel off following the arrow, and then step two is just to stick the two ends together. So Jialing will demonstrate how we do that. So as I was talking through the bag tag printing, the boarding pass was also printed. So you also realize the sequence of which we designed the print. Because bag tag is new to many passengers, we wanted the bag tag to print first before the boarding pass. Otherwise, many passengers would have taken the boarding pass and walked away, thinking that that's the end of the process. Yeah. So okay, we are done with the bag tagging. If no questions, or we can take the questions.